I'm still stuck on a logo redesign. I have no idea what I want to do.
I just imagine you've been staring at a blank Photoshop document for an hour.
It's almost blank. It has hexagons.
Nice.
There are hexagons on that page.
You're a valiant ally, and I'm glad that you're here with me to take out General Grievous. I certainly hope you don't betray me immediately after the general is killed.
Would you think that?
No reason. That'd just be really an unfortunate thing to have happen right now.
Yes, it would.
Cody, help me!
Help me, Cody!
Help me! Help me!
Look!
I don't work that way anymore.
And then he shoots Obi-Wan with the fucking laser.
Can't believe that's how the betrayal played out.
Well, it's also, the clones also have chips in their brains to, like, activate Order 66, so he legitimately does not work like that anymore.
Yeah.
Stop it. Stop it, Cody. This is not funny, Cody. One of these days you'll hit me.
One of these days you'll stop trying to hit me and hit me.
Look at Grievous bragging. You wasted studs!
You know, Humble Bundle, when you advertise Hello Neighbor in your bundle, make me want to not buy it.
I don't want a key anywhere near me.
I don't want to touch this franchise.
Oh, I knew it. We should have brought Jar Jar.
He's the key to all this.
Ow!
Nothing happened
here. Fucking broke my neck!
That was just your helmet. You're fine.
I think he broke that guy's neck.
Marty snaps Biff's neck and just runs away. I think he broke his neck. Yeah, Marty.
The coach is like, I don't work like that. Turns his head back around.
Marty goes back in time and kills Biff's parents. I don't work like that no more. It fades back into existence.
Let's see that. No.
All right.
This is the best. This is the best stream.
It is the best stream. How are we gonna get
best
up there?
Best stream on Twitter.
This is the funniest stream we've done before. If it works, the whole channel works.
It's the second stream we've ever done. It's the second stream we've ever done as the Beehive. First stream was at Noah's house playing Half-Life 2 Deathmatch. Can the camera stop fucking me over?
Did we stream that?
I streamed Half-Life 2 Deathmatch on I think my Twitch channel.
Okay.
I thought we had made one beforehand, and Logan and I spent like half an hour trying to log into an account that didn't exist.
Yeah, that'll put a dent in things.
Yeah. And then after that, it's like, yeah, this is a clusterfuck. We can't stream in the same room. It's just echoey. It's just a nightmare. You can't hear anybody.
Ooh.
Let's get back to Grievous. High on the ball, Cody. Once we kill Grievous, we can go home.
I don't know, Obi-Wan. I'm paid by the hour.
How can he do that?
Because labor laws are very lax in the outer world.
There are no hand railings anywhere.
The ADA did not exist in this timeline.
Nor does OSHA.
I keep thinking about Marty breaking Biff's neck. And then Biff rejecting it and unbreaking his own neck. Can we get up there? Do we need Jar Jar?
That goes back up to where you're standing there.
Yeah. Oh! Cody, no!
I don't work like that.
I have no studs. Look at our studs. We have 110 studs between us. And you have all of them.
Sounds like you're not holding up your end of the bargain.
We're not here to make money.
What in the fuck? That plane is so low to the ground!
IRL.
Why?
Playing Flight Simulator?
No! I'm playing your life!
Oh, I hate that game.
I mean, I know I live near an airport, but that was a very low level plane.
So uncivilized.
Oh, we get somewhere so low.
Right, Cody?
Oh, that was Utapau.
Just blows on the fucking gun.
Yes, it was Utapau. Why?
So uncivilized.
Why was that a surprise?
Because it doesn't fucking look like Utapau.
3% true Jedi. I got you for 3%.
Did I like black out for a second? Because I saw you guys at the beginning of episode 3. Now you're just at the end.
Yeah, you got hit by a plane.
Oh, that's true.
You were in a coma for a while.
What did they get hit by a plane by too?
Yeah, I was explaining to Logan that all the time my avatar is Bill Wilson, except on 9/11 when I'm George Bush. But the constant is that I'm always a failed government official who was involved in a plane crash.
That's true.
Ah.
Did that Wookiee have a mohawk?
A blonde mohawk.
I don't exactly know what that's supposed to be. I thought blonde it was like mohawk. A headpiece or something.
No, it's clearly a blonde mohawk.
We're already on Kashyyyk. The droid attack
just
on the
imagine
Wookiee
being this Wookiee that just sees this old man get dropped off. And like he's just using a cane, like barely able to get around. He just does a couple fucking double front flips in the air.
Translate to that means, whoa, that shit was badass.
I didn't know he could do that.
I asked the level where we get
why
to
can't
clones.
He do that in the sequels?
Chewie, oh, get back here.
What are they doing over there, those clones?
They're hanging out.
Just fucking vibing.
Down the street, vibing, the same old
receiving
thing
Order 66, you know.
Now thing
standard
to do.
Stuff.
Vibing with Order 66.
Vibing with Sheev.
That should be a podcast.
Vibing with Sheev.
Vibing with Sheev.
That was a fierce battle. Oh, fuck.
Uh-oh.
Those are chips activating.
Betray my friends?
They can't hit anything!
They became stormtroopers instantly.
Immediately. As soon as they became evil, they couldn't hit anything. Remember, remember we saw The Rise of Skywalker and they were running through the hallway and the stormtroopers were hitting nothing and I leaned over and said, they can't fucking hit anything! And then Poe got shot in the shoulder after that.
Yeah.
That was fucking ridiculous. It was just a hallway. Don't miss.
I fucking hate that movie. That movie was a disaster.
We can't live down the fact that we were semi-impressed with it when it ended. And then as we talked about it, it just broke down every single piece of it.
Yeah, the second we were allowed to think about what happened.
It's like, we had the time to think about it, and it's like, wait, what?
Yeah, like, while the movie is happening, you have no time to think. It's like, yes, this thing happened. Oh, next. Don't think about where he was.
Like, on the way to the car, too.
Yeah.
Just like,
yeah, we got in the car, and it's like, oh, yeah, I didn't like that. I didn't like that. And it's like, yeah, okay. What about this plot hole? Oh, I didn't like that. It's like, wait a minute.
And then he came back to my apartment. We just talked about it at 2 a.m.
Yeah. I especially...
So.
Excellent hairdo.
More bangable you are.
I'm on a ketamine high, I don't judge. Any species, anytime.
Oh god.
My favorite, I read a description of what the fuck is the assassin's name in that movie?
Sam Wessel?
No, in Rise of Skywalker.
Oh, the chick? I have no idea.
No, not Zori. The Sith assassin who had the dagger who died. Hoshi? No, Uchi?
I don't remember who you're fucking talking. Oh yeah, the one that was already dead.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, you said you were banking on him not actually existing, and then he existed.
Yeah. I mean, in a weird kind of way, he kind of existed.
Yeah. What's his name? Hold on. It's bothering me. I was reading his name. Sith Assassin. I was reading his name in leaks forever, and I can't remember what it was. This is a leak discussing about how a Sith dagger. Yes, what is this character's name? That's just called Sith Assassin. He has a name.
That's his name.
Ochi, that's his name.
Ochi, oh yeah, okay.
Ochi?
What is copyright?
Yeah.
Why do I have a pop-up about copyright information in my Steam overlay? Get out of here. Mm-hmm. I don't want to learn.
It's very important that you know about that.
But I saw a description of Ochi where, like, he was a complete and utter failure who transcribes the Emperor's location on a dagger, goes to Pisana, looks around for 5 seconds to find Rey's parents, finds them, kills them, immediately takes their word for it that Rey isn't on the planet, goes to get drunk, and then falls in a hole 5 feet from a ship and dies.
Yeah. Yeah. A brilliant character arc.
Mission accomplished. The Emperor will be pleased. I will go, I killed his clone and his clone's wife, and now I'll go celebrate with drink. And, where's my ship? Oh, fuck. Oh, I got eaten by a worm. Fuck.
Darn.
This is what happens when you have everybody write their own part of the trilogy. It was okay the first time because they didn't know it was gonna fucking happen.
Yeah. Yeah.
But even then, they managed to pull it together better than these yahoos did.
Yeah, the sister reveal at the end of Return of the Jedi, or midway through Return of the Jedi, at the beginning of Return of the Jedi is... Eh. But...
Yeah.
It still came together fine. But it's like...
Then this planned trilogy was a dumpster fire compared
to... It wasn't
to,
planned.
There was an
article. Horrible.
There was an article that came out recently that
said... The problem, though, is it was planned. They knew they were going to make 3 movies to begin with.
Yeah.
Yeah, they planned on making 3 movies. They planned nothing else about those movies.
That's the problem. This
going
planned
to make,
trilogy
going
wasn't
to make
planned.
Money. Thank you, Bob Iger, for that astute observation.
The original movie, they didn't know it was going to be a trilogy.
Well, I know
it
that.
It was going to be one movie.
But it continued very well, and there were a lot of loose ends that you could build off of. Just like Force Awakens. Force Awakens was fine on its own, but now, like, in the trilogy, it's just as useless as the other fucking movies now.
It
was made retroactively worse.
It was just a tug of war. It's like, we're doing this, now we're doing this, now we're doing this.
It's because J.J. Abrams and his puzzle box of ideas that he never answers is a terrible
philosophy
for making
movies. And then
Ryan Johnson
was like, this sucks, I'm not doing this, and so he didn't do it. But then we end up with a middle movie that doesn't accomplish anything.
Yeah,
I would have been severely more interested in just having an entire trilogy by Ryan Johnson rather than a lot of people just want to get rid of the fucking middle movie. It's like, no, I feel like if Abrams had the full trilogy, it'd still be bad. He'd still find a way to fuck it up.
I agree. Ryan Johnson would have done better if he'd started the trilogy.
Yeah, he would have been better off having the entire trilogy because, like, some of his ideas were interesting, and he didn't try to, like, summon any weird force voodoo.
I guess.
At least I don't think he did.
The force projection was kind of odd. Like, it was new.
Yeah, okay, yeah, he did introduce that, didn't he?
Yeah, like, JJ was the one who made it so it can, like, pass stuff through space-time, but...
Or the force cleric.
I like the force projection on its own. Don't pass things through space-time, JJ.
Yes, Chewbacca, build! You'll make a great Wookiee slave when building the Death Star.
Yeah.
Anyway, look at all these clones. I like how they spawn infinitely. As a lad, I would just stand on this beach and just kill them as they would come in. Just good combat.
Do you even get anything for it?
No. It's okay. Okay, we have this now.
This murder. What the fuck is that? Do you build an AT-AT walker?
Yeah. Well, actually, this is a...
ATRT?
I actually don't know.
I think it's an AT-AT.
No, an AT-AT is... That's definitely not an AT-AT.
Oh yeah, those don't exist yet.
Yeah, and they're also...
Yeah, those are four-legged fuckers.
Oh, they're the four-legged
ones.
Okay.
I thought AT-ST was a big one.
No, AT-AT,
no,
AT-AT
is
the big one.
AT-ST
is the
enclosed one in,
AT-ST.
Like, Endor.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's a two-legged...
Chicken walker.
Yeah, AT-ST. All-terrain scout transport. That's the smaller one.
I think these are the AT-ERTs.
AT-ERTs.
It's something.
You ripped that man's arm off and then punched a Jedi Master.
All-terrain armored transport is the big one, so that's the AT-AT, yeah. Is it really all-terrain?
I mean,
I'm pretty sure, like, the flying things would be better at all-terrain.
They used it on
snow. So the purpose of the AT-ATs was to have heavy fire on planets with weird magnetic fields that would mess with the hover drives.
Weren't there ships flying around them?
On Hoth?
I don't know, mate.
On Hoth, yeah.
Well, they were smaller ships. They were smaller ships. I'm wondering if
they might have been better designed
like
for those.
Maybe for that specific. Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. They also use the AT-ATs on Scarif when they go get the Death Star plans.
For no reason.
There was also briefly one on Endor.
Other than fan service.
There was. Oh yeah, there was one on Endor. It gets crushed by a couple of logs. Or no, that's an AT-ST.
Did you know that the snow speeder is called a T-47 airspeed?
Don't they take Luke onto an AT-AT?
Oh yeah, yeah they do. Vader meets him there.
Oh.
Vader meets him after he gets off. Or gets on, something
Vader,
like that.
Vader
yes.
gets off?
This is where I get off.
I'm pretty sure that they were only ever added to like look cool.
Yeah, I liked Road Letter Media's explanation of it. We need some thing to walk forward on the snow planet. Okay, I designed this. Oh, that's cool. And then they just kept using it for everything else.
Yeah.
Where do we go?
I don't know. I gotta kill the natural plant life.
That's fair.
The fern wants to know your location.
Oh no.
I mean, if you think about it, like, lore-wise, it makes sense they'd only have one model that they deploy anywhere. It's cheaper that way.
Yeah.
Well,
but,
yeah.
Yeah, just have it be all-purposes.
Yeah. Like, they have... They're clearly able to, like, have Star Destroyers float above an atmosphere.
I know what this is!
Well, Hoth had a shield on it, right? I thought they had to pick up a generator.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, yeah, but they're...
But, they've
but
still
that
got
wasn't
the
shielding...
Yeah.
Or, yeah.
It was shielding the base. It wasn't shielding the planet.
Yeah, they just got
That's
on
true.
The planet on a post.
The only... time that they ever used a planet-wide shield was in Rogue One.
Oh yeah, and that was Scarif.
Yeah, and that was cool as fuck. I like that idea where it's like one gate.
Rogue One has my favorite space battle in the entire franchise.
Oh yeah, it looks coolest
it's,
by
it's
far.
The best, it's the best space battle.
Yeah, by far.
Having fun there, Chewie?
You just wouldn't wake up.
Seeing two Star Destroyers mash into each other with New Age debris tech is beautiful and amazing, and
That's
I love
great.
It. It's better than Death Star Go Explode.
Mr. Death Star Go Explode.
From New Hope. Where there's just nothing left. It's just like you set off a fucking firecracker the size of a
Get out of there, Wedge!
Moon.
You can't do any more good out there! Oh, hey,
wait,
that's the
wait.
Battle with wait, yeah.
Oh, God, yeah.
Where have we seen this before? I know what this is. Does this ship even exist yet? I don't think it does.
Pictionary intensifies.
I don't think it does, yeah. Ooh, I had one of those, actually.
I need, no, we need Jar Jar, God damn it.
I had one of those, an actual Lego one. It was much larger than that.
Much larger
I clap
than,
when I saw
than the one that
beam.
Yoda just lifted out of the swamp.
Yeah, but much larger.
It was life size.
Life size out of Legos, yes. It was a great Christmas gift.
Good God.
You bought me a
spaceship?
No. A bunch of plastic bricks that you can turn into a spaceship.
But it has a hyperdrive. Yay!
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 Build your own hyperdrive out of Lego.
You activate the hyperdrive and you just get ripped apart.
Build the hyperdrive.
And escape the Empire. Wait, the Empire has hyperspace tracking.
Hey!
Hey!
Board the Star Destroyer. Disable the tracking. Wait, the Empire knew you were coming.
Hey! Make a new movie to contradict everything afterwards.
Hey, perform the hyperspace ram. Wait. And free the rebellion. Wait. They tracked you to the salt planet.
Hey!
Taste to see if it's actually salt.
It is.
Hey!
The new salt collection from Lego Star Wars.
Wait.
Kill the
wait.
Rebels.
The Empire
wait.
Has a laser cannon and they're gonna blow up the door.
Hey!
Build the speeder and fly straight into the laser cannon and then get bashed by your dumbass girlfriend.
Not even girlfriend. Just shoehorned love interest, more.
But then gets written out of the movie, which was a just, writing
yeah,
problem, not an actor problem. They should
that.
They could have just
yeah,
written
no.
her better. They could have just written her better
fine.
And kept her in.
Yeah.
But no, they just got rid of her because they were fucking scared.
Yeah, they turned her into a fucking side character.
And then,
shame. She's
and
a
then,
good actress.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like her.
They could have done something interesting with the character, but they didn't.
Yeah.
No.
They just that's the whole thing. They could have done something interesting, but they didn't.
That's the entire trilogy right there.
JJ, make an interesting movie. I don't work like that no more.
No, I don't think
no,
I will.
That's fucking George Lucas that fucking said that. Hey, George, can you come back and just write, like, a basic outline of a trilogy for us?
Well, he did, and then they threw it out.
Did he?
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah. He sold them his outline, and then they threw it away.
Really?
Like,
yes.
Thank you, George. Very cool.
Thanks,
release
George.
The George script.
Release the George script. Stop stepping on Yoda. Release the George script and stop stepping on Yoda, please.
Hey!
build the steel-toed boot.
Film the trilogy.
And crush Yoda into a pulp. Oh! The new CBT collection from Lego Star Wars.
Oh, no.
Now for sale exclusively in the Disney store.
I'm sure they'd be very happy to sell that.
This is a pretty view.
We got
here.
One of those in the mall around us, like and every that. Time I walk by it, I just feel like a pedophile just walking by it.
But walking by what?
Disney store.
Oh, because like I'm assuming it has like a lot of like pink, like Elsa and Mickey, Minnie Mouse stuff and Mickey Mouse
yeah,
and everything.
Yeah, it caters exclusively to small children.
Uh huh. I remember one of those. I never wanted anything from it because I was too old for it. But I remember looking around in one a long time ago. Yeah, just go in there, and it's just like immediately Chris Hansen is just, why don't you take a seat? No!
You don't understand.
I like Mickey Mouse.
A likely sure story. Nobody likes Mickey Mouse. Good point.
Like House
of Mouse.
Oh yeah,
I was gonna buy House Flipper. It's on sale now.